Join the Our Game Supporters Club at Patreon for €5 per month to get audio podcasts of the Hurling and Football Show and much more exclusive material.
Michael Verney, you watched Offaly win their first national title in 23 years. I was there as well. Quite a thrill to see them and beat Roscommon in the manner that they did.
Absolutely majestic, yeah. Ah, jeez, it was great. So we're absolutely starved of that. We waited 23 years for that. I was two the last time they won an under-21 title in 1988. Funnily enough, I don't have any recollection of it, surprisingly enough. I think it's the nature of the way they play. Yeah, fair enough, they play a sweeper. Rushing Keenan Martin goes back and plays sweeper when they're defending. But they were attacking in waves. And you're looking at, you know, Cottle Donoghue, Jack Bryant, Aaron Callaghan, Cormac Egan, and you're thinking there's three or four like really good attackers to burst on the scene over the next, you know, 4 to 5 years, which is just a really exciting prospect. Morgan Tynan in midfield, brilliant. Just everything around yesterday. I was walking up Drumcondra around what was it, about 1:45, I'd say, and like every of them off, he was just gone bonkers already. The ball hadn't even thrown up and they were just gone fecking mad, and it was great. They just the want and thirst for it. Everyone's just been waiting for it for so long. And I think the way they play, that's so easy on the eye. Like I was saying to one of the lads last night, we're like, that team is the envy of everybody in the country. Like everyone would be proud to be following that team and the way that they play. And it's just great. And it does, one of the viewers mentioned earlier, like it does just go to show you when you have your house in order, what can happen. Did I think even in my, you know, over the next 20 years that I'd see Offaly winning All-Ireland of any description? I would have doubted it. And all of a sudden, it's about 20 months since Michael Deignan and his team, Dervil Dolan and Colm Cummins and a few more guys went in over the county board. And it's just absolutely turned upside down. And like, we believe now. You believe in the structures that are there. You believe in the people that are there. And yeah, it was just phenomenal. And I think the way that they won it as well, the fact that the Roscommon got a massive bounce from the bench and left just a goal in it going down injury time. If you're going to win, I'd rather win hanging on any day of the week just for the sheer drama of it all and not knowing. Like I was doing a snap report for online, and it was just like the opening par, and I felt guilty writing it with 5 minutes to go. I was like, Offaly win their first All-Ireland since of any description since 1998. And I was like, geez, I nearly delete that, like, because I'm tempting fate here. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's what it felt like. And thankfully, I was able to leave it there. But it was just such dramatic circumstances to see, like, you know, Shane Lowry has won, you know, an Open Championship, and he's won an Irish Open, and he's probably going to play in the Ryder Cup next month. But I don't know if he will ever be as happy as he was yesterday in Croke Park. Like, he was like a child. It was just like it was like a child embracing his father, Brendan, and everything. And that's why everyone was like, there was boys telling me last night they were crying at the final whistle. And I didn't even know if some of these lads had the capabilities to even cry at any occasion. You know, it was just absolutely phenomenal. It was in the Celt for a few hours last night, an awfully pub, and it just unbelievable just to see everybody and see how happy. That's what I'm saying about the GAA earlier. We've done a lot wrong in Ireland, but geez, the GAA, there's so much right about the GAA.
And how much do you put down to, you know, Michael Deignan and co coming in? How much do you put down to the management team? How much do you like to Dave Hare, who I think has done the S&C with these lads the last few years? They look in great shape. You know, like Cormac Egan, he burst forward, took a ball off the shoulder of possibly Jack Bryant and burst the defender onto the ground and knocked it over from a tight angle. So there's a lot of different people, but like, yeah, how much is each direction? Probably hard to define, but yeah, a lot of people getting credit.
Those development squads were probably turned around about 5 or 6 years ago, and they're that crew now are one of the first crews to come through. Basically, Shane, we were miles behind strength conditioning wise, and Dave Hare and others doing massive work. Dave has obviously gone, he's in St. Jude's now, but deserves massive credit as well. Just to mention as well, Vinnie Claffey and Colm Quinn in the background there, you know, organising a lot of the various personnel involved with the various underage teams. It's not just Michael Deignan or anyone else, or, you know, Declan Kelly's been there for 4 years. He's gotten them really competitive and really, really consistent now as well. There's a lot of different factors at play, but definitely, you know, Lowry coming on board, Deignan coming in, the things were moving. But all of a sudden, from moving at a decent pace, they're just absolutely, it's all kind of snowballed very, very quickly now. And yeah, it's just unbelievable even to see the lads in, you know, in Tullamore last night, and they know there was no homecoming. I'd say there'll be several small little homecomings around all the 40-something clubs in Offaly over the next while, and God, by God, they definitely deserve it too.
Yeah, it was brilliant just to see an unlikely All-Ireland final pairing of Roscommon. Yeah. And Roscommon have been there before. And, you know, for those Offaly players, given the dominance of Dublin in Leinster, and, you know, Offaly are a long way from winning All-Ireland, this might be the biggest title that any of these players ever win. I think a lot of those Roscommon lads will fancy that maybe they'll win a Connacht title in years to come. So I don't think you can underestimate the importance of this. Like, COMP Co-Production says, if you're asking about what will come from this Offaly Under-20 team, it will be a competitive senior team for the next decade with three big semi-finals down the road. Feels like the tip minor win. Like, do you feel like it's moving that direction? And even, like, has John Mahon, what he's done at the senior level and obviously the county board level beyond that, does it feel like Offaly is moving in the right direction?
No, definitely, yeah. Like, John Mahon has turned around the senior team. That senior team is now of a really good age profile that over the next 3 or 4 years, these guys will be able to blend in. Like, I would have always worried what would happen when Niall McNamee retires, like one of our greatest ever players. But there's a succession plan in place now. You know, he's blooded a load of young fellas. There's guys playing for the seniors this year that just wouldn't maybe have been expecting them to play as soon as they have. They've settled in there, gone really well. And these guys will blend in over the next 3 or 4 years. The key thing, though, is just to be patient with them. Like, Cormac Egan has only gone 18, like, you know what I mean? Like, he's as much of a bull as he is, like, he's only just gone 18. He's going to need another 3 or 4 years before he can, you know, realistically make a mark at senior level. And that's the same for a lot of those guys. But I think that the structures are in place to make sure that they're given the best opportunity to come through and give the senior a right good rattling over the next couple of years. And it's exciting. Like, we will mine this team now. We will mine as many as possible out of this team. It's not like a Dublin or, you know, a Cork or even a Tip winning an underage title. It's different from a smaller county. Like, we need as many of these lads to come through as possible. We can't let anybody slip through the net. And I think they're very mindful of that already. Declan Kelly said yesterday that they were already having a conversation of, regardless of the result, that lads don't lose the run of themselves, that lads remember the bigger picture, that lads remember why they're doing it and where they want to go to. So I think, yeah, I think all the right things are in place to allow those lads to flourish over the next while.
Park Gill says, small counties need at least three strong, separate underage teams to make it through at senior. Likes of Dublin only need a couple of individuals every couple of years. That's because the foundation is so strong that you just need to top up and top up and top up. That's why it's important that John Mahon has things turned around, as you've kind of described, so that he can just add more layers, and he's bringing players into a good culture, and it's not a case of players almost getting turned away. Like, you want to bring players into an environment where they're like, geez, I need to even step up my training again, or my diet up again, or whatever it might be, so that I can dislodge this lad who's been playing senior for a few years. And then the senior guy is thinking, oh God, Cormac Egan and Jack Bryant, etc. are coming. I need to step up my game. And then you end up with this unbelievable culture. And that's probably just what hasn't been there before, but is there now.
Yeah, no, I'd agree with you. I'd agree with you. There's a high performance culture there now that just was absent up until a couple of years ago. And in fairness, the Faithful Fields cost a lot of money at the time, and, you know, Kieran Keenan, who was involved in Banner Concrete, was huge behind that. But they're really milking everything out of that. They're using it to the max at the moment. There's only two kind of full-time GPOs at the moment, in spread between Eden Derry Club and one that's spread between Burris or Kieran and Drumcullen. I know they're hoping to have 10 to 12 by the end of the year. There's a level of ambition there. And Lowry coming on board has increased funds going in. And it's also pricked ears up to think, why aren't I contributing to my county if I'm, you know, a wealthy Offaly native in New York or something like that? So, and like, this will help the whole thing explode. It will, like, it just, everyone will want to be part of it, even if it's in the background or doing anything, you know?
Yeah. I haven't seen you as happy since you had a sausage last week.
I tell you, those Super Queen sausages are a joy to behold. I'll be going doing a bit of shopping later. Jeez, I look absolutely hammered in that picture.
And he doesn't even drink. That's the whole thing of it.
Oh, God above, Jerry Mack. Yeah, no. Good times. Let the good times roll.
Join the Our Game Supporters Club at Patreon for €5 per month to get audio podcasts of the Hurling and Football Show and much more exclusive material.